the people who were intended to work or weren't intended to go straight away to the Zyklon B crematoria were showered, and that's really happened. And it was a true story, as the story is. That incident was true. Both the women and the men were showered, and then eventually Oscar Schindler came and rescued them. So he's mistaken. But however, I can see the point. And when I finished shooting that scene, one of the things that worried me was I didn't want to play into the hands of the what they call the Holocaust deniers. So I shot the scene that comes directly after that, where the same women who were spared when the water came out witness the long lines of very newly transported Jews who were actually going into the gas chambers, and the camera pans up and shows their remains coming, going into the sky.
Het is nooit helemaal duidelijk geworden hoe de opportunistische Schindler tot zijn dappere daad kwam. Steven Spielberg weet het ook niet.
And I'm not sure really why he did it. Later he told people he did it because he always cared for the Jews. I certainly think that's somebody who read all the articles on himself, and he was honored by the Yad Vashem, and a tree was planted in his name. He's a righteous person. And certainly at that point you're going to say that I always knew what I was doing. I'm not quite sure Schindler did know what he was doing based on people I've talked to who knew Schindler during the war. And that's why in my film it's more ambiguous than certain. But I would have asked him that question.
En wat was de motivatie van Spielberg om dit verhaal te vertellen?
How do you put an emotion on something that's so horrendous it's almost unspeakable, ineffable? And I didn't want my characters to be drawn into the trap of melodrama. And I felt the best way to, and I must say, the best way I began was when Steve Zalian wrote the first screenplay. Steve made the choice to be very removed from the subject. And that way it allows you to make a choice of how involved you want to become. I don't push your involvement, I offer you this. I say about Schindler's List, I say, look at this. And that's all I'm saying with the movie. I'm simply saying, look at this. And then you draw your own conclusions. But I'm not saying, as I do with most of my films, you must look at this. I'm just saying, look at this.
Is hij niet bang dat de Holocaust nu ook door minder integere regisseurs zou worden gebruikt om duistere exploitatiefilms te maken?
I think that the Holocaust is such a delicate subject that I really believe that if anybody does another film like this, it'll be full of integrity and very well done and full of restraint.
En heeft hij wel eens nagedacht dat het onderwerp zo gevoelig lag dat Schindler's List misschien maar beter niet gemaakt kon worden?
No, I was motivated by just the opposite. That the biggest crime, the biggest sin would be to stand still and do nothing. Because we've been standing still and doing nothing about this for many years. Claude Lanzmann's documentary has been seen by very few people. Shadows and Fog has been seen by hardly anyone. Documentaries just aren't seen. I think that Shoah will be seen now because of Schindler's. And Shoah is a brilliant documentary. And I have great respect for all the filmmakers who made Shoah happen. Shoah was a big influence on me. I saw the picture many times before making Schindler's List. But I don't believe there can be any one expert on the Holocaust. I think some of the things that Claude is reacting to is, I think he feels a bit dethroned, that he's not the last word on the Holocaust. I think that everybody with a passion to tell the story needs to tell the story, whether it's Claude Lanzmann, whether it's Elie Wiesel. People should read the books of Primo Levi. Everybody, should not be denied the Holocaust as an instrument of remembrance and communication. And so my feeling is that there's room for all of these films. I also don't believe that one Holocaust filmmaker should criticize another Holocaust filmmaker. I think that there are critics out there that are paid to criticize us, and that's fine. I don't believe that filmmakers should criticize filmmakers. And I just think that that remembering is much more important than any individual ego. And I certainly have no ego, and I hope somebody comes out and makes another movie about the Holocaust that is much more profound than my own. I do know one thing. Film is the most powerful instrument of persuasion around. The whole communications medium, film, television, those two powerhouses really get people to see things differently. had there been no cameras in the marketplace in Sarajevo 2 weeks ago, and we just heard that 68 people were killed and 200 were injured by that 102 or millimeter shell that was lobbed in from the mountains by the Serbs, there wouldn't be such a worldwide outcry toward action, toward doing something about it. But because there were cameras there and it caught the aftermath, it just rocked the world. I mean, the visual medium is very, very strong. So if Schindler's List can make a little crack in people's intolerance, in people's basically in their make a crack in their own lack of interest in the subject, then I think we'll have accomplished a great deal.